Apple few days ago started brand new era for Apple, most probably even for the whole computer industry. Apple WWDC 2020 keynote was the most important for the Mac since the arrival of macOS 10 two decades ago. Apple is transitioning a whole computer lineup from Intel to ARM-based Apple Silicon. Should you fear about it or celebrate? Should you buy a new Mac right now or wait? Will the new macOS 11 Big Sur be same disaster as macOS 10.15 Catalina? What about Bootcamp? Even more I will try to uncover in this video. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonau.cloud and I provide personal individual support with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux and server builds. So if you would need any help, just join my website membership, link is in this video description. And I will help you while Skype video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Make sure you click the subscribe button below, hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. Sorry, I have to say that. I was disappointed from the WWDC 2020 keynote a bit. Not by all the exciting, amazing news, but from the form. I expected to be a really live event, even without any audience. Not a pre-recorded, little bit cold and robotic presentation. I always remember how I was waiting full of excitement for the start of each keynote, for those amazing live moments on stage and Steve Jobs' humor. But anyway, it's gone. Anyway, speculations about Apple could switch to their own CPUs in Apple computers were flying through internet for a few years already. Some people were skeptical about it, but look, for example, at performance of latest iPad Pro. It's already now faster than 92% of all portable PCs. And it's running on Apple A12 SoC. By the way, the developer kit for building new apps for the ARM Apple Silicon is running also A12 chip, as in the iPad Pro. With much less power consumption, much cooler. So the whole idea of using Apple Silicon ARM CPUs in their computers is good, and I highly welcome it. People should not fear about lack of performance. It should be powerful enough. Look at, for example, currently most powerful supercomputer called Fukaku. It's powered by Numero's 48-core ARM CPUs. Apple went through such major transition two times already. macOS 10.5 Leopard was the last system for the PowerPC architecture used in Apple Mac computers before Apple switched to Intel CPUs completely in 2006. macOS 10.6 Snow Leopard was first Apple's operating system designed to run on Intel-based Apple Macs only. So, what did that mean for users of the old PowerPC architecture? Well, in fact, quite nothing. The PowerPC macOS 10.5 people could use forever on their older computers, and if they would buy the new Intel-powered Mac, they still had the option to run apps designed only for PowerPC on those new Intel Macs. The macOS 10.6 system was, let's say, some kind of dual system. It was equipped with so-called Rosetta compatibility layer, which let you run PowerPC apps on Intel CPUs. And it also introduced so-called universal apps. Those apps were written to run on both platforms, PowerPC and Intel. Single app capable of running natively on both platforms. Isn't that amazing? Yes, and now guess what? Tim Cook, a few days ago on the WWDC 2020 keynote, announced the new macOS 11 Big Sur. How is the successor of the 10.15 Catalina called? Even I don't like it. But anyway, Big Sur macOS 11 will contain Universal 2 and Rosetta 2. So the same principle as was used when switching from PowerPC to Intel CPUs in 2006. So the macOS 11 Big Sur and apps will be running natively on Intel-based Apple computers as well as on the new ones, equipped with Apple Silicon ARM-based CPUs. It's clear now, Apple will one day have full lineup of computers with Apple Silicon inside only. When? Tim Cook said Apple planned to switch all Apple computers to their own ARM-based CPUs in 2 years. He also said two important things. One, Intel-based Macs will continue get support for years to come. And second, Apple is planning to release even more Intel-based Apple computers in future. As always, in the past, older Apple computers were supported for a lot of years. Look, for example, at the 2013 Mac Pro. Apple claims it's gonna be supported even on the macOS 11 Big Sur. So computer released in 2013 with originally macOS 10.9 system will be getting support even in year 2021. So it's for 8 years, whole 7 macOS generations. Do you think, let's say, people who invested fortune into 2019 Mac Pro will be out of luck and without support in just 2 years when Apple will complete the transition to ARM CPUs only? No, of course not. Intel-based CPUs will be still supported for a really lot of years from now. So there is no need to panic here if you are running some important or big production on Intel Macs. And what about the macOS Big Sur itself? Look. It has very nice design, pleasant for eye. Fine. But will it be usable? It's first iteration of brand new architecture. So for sure, there will be dozens and dozens of problems and bugs. Will Apple fix all bugs prior to launch of the new ARM-based Macs later this year? I bet, unfortunately, not. Look at example of macOS 10.15 Catalina. It's on the market almost 10 months already, in .5 version. And it's a piece of crap. This is $24,000 2019 Mac Pro. And it's crashing. It's randomly freezing. I cannot check all my email accounts. I cannot access my own website. It cannot sleep. What the hell? So, macOS Catalina is another macOS version, which should be historically completely skipped. So, based on experience with Catalina, I will hold myself back from upgrading to macOS 11 Big Sur on my production machines for a really long time. So, those who can still run Mojave, be happy with Mojave and stay on it. Those forced to Catalina, be unhappy with Catalina and pray for Big Sur will be finally better. So, and what about bootcamp? Great Federig said, there will be no bootcamp. Period. Finito. Instead of it, Apple announced to virtualization support in the new macOS 11 Big Sur. How good? How fast? Well, we have to wait for this answer. So, what's my recommendation according to buying a new Mac now or wait for ARM-based one later this year? Apple software chief Craig Federighi said again, we can expect, quote, summer full of excitement. Tim Cook said, Apple plans to release new Intel-based Macs in future. There is no doubt those Intel Macs will be better than previous ones. We'll get probably new iMac with new design, maybe Navy GPU. But new Apple computers equipped with the Apple Silicon based on ARM architecture will be for sure better and also powerful plenty enough. It will not suffer from overheating issues like current Intel-based Macs thanks to lower power consumption. It will be more future-proof and maybe it could be even a little bit cheaper when everything will be built on in-house technologies. But as I know Apple, I would be skeptical about the price. So, if you need a Mac now, or if you want one now, do it. Just buy a Mac now. But if you are not under pressure, I would personally wait till the end of the year and buy the new Apple Silicon equipped Mac. That's what I personally plan to do. So, here you have it. Future is starting right now. If you would need any help with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux and server builds, just join my website membership, link is in this video description, and I will help you while Skype video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Make sure you click the subscribe button below, hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends so it can help to more people. Morgonaut is always here to help. And of course, don't forget to watch my other videos. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Macintosh friends.